the microphone and the limelight. But, you know, there is something I'd love to share with you. Now, if any of you are here because you think that I'm an expert in network marketing or multi-level marketing, I'm not. I don't know anything about that. In fact, I'm very uncomfortable with it. As you guys know, I'm a doctor. My whole life has been spent in learning how to treat and take care of disease. I'm a surgeon, and so like we say in surgery, if we can't cut it out, we can't cure it. So you're not here for that, I know. And so what happened was, throughout my growing up, I realized that health was important to me. But I also realized that one of the unhealthiest communities in our nation happens to be right here in Guam. I don't know if you guys realize that. We have a heart attack age that's 10 years younger than the national average. 10 years younger. Well, how do I know that? My family, we got proof of that. My dad died of a massive heart attack at age 45. 45. My grandfather died of a heart attack at 47. His dad. 47. I have a brother. I'm not going to mention who he is, but he's sitting right over here. Who had his first bypass, heart bypass, when he was 35. Then he had his second bypass, a redo, when he was 45. But he's not unique. Our family is not unique with our disease. On Guam, we have the highest rates of smoking in the whole United States. Men, women, and children. We have an explosion of cancer going on right now as we speak. I mean, I bet you there's somebody, and there's everybody in here is related or knows somebody that either has cancer or is dying of it. Everybody in here is related or has it or knows somebody that has diabetes. That's a tumoral disease, we say. We're very unhealthy, but yet, 70 years ago, immediately after World War II, the United States Navy did a survey of the Pacific Islands. And they looked at all the disease types, and guess how many cases of diabetes they found right after the war. Now, remember, we lead the nation now. We have some of the highest rates of diabetes in the United States right now. Guam, Hawaii, and American Samoa. We have the highest rates. So imagine, 70 years ago, right after the war, how many diabetics do you think they found on Guam at that time? Zero. What happened? Is it in our genes, or was it something that happened that could have been prevented? Prior to the war, the Tamorals were out fishing, farming, working hard, getting exercise, eating taro, eating fish, breadfruit, banana, fishing, eating fish. After World War II, when the United States came, they wiped out everything here in Guam and they made us dependent. And so what came with the U.S., the United States Marine Army and the sailors?
Spam.
But remember, guys, we didn't have any meat. You know that the only real native mammal to Guam was the finiki, the bat. The deer, the pigs, the cows were brought in through the Spanish time. And so that's why the bat became a sort of a delicacy for us, like here in Guam. Now it's extinct, we don't get it anymore. So right after the war, we were wanting meat. And I'll tell you, some of the best tasting food in the world is what? Fatty, salty, and fried. Ah, I love that stuff too. But look at what it's done to us as a people. It's made us very, very unhealthy. Very, very unhealthy. And so I realized then, way back when I first came to Guam, when I got back down with my residency, was that I noticed there are two lines of Tamorals that were dying out. We see the older people that were already prior to the war had certain habits. Some of the older people living into their 90s and to their late 80s And their children, unfortunately, in their 50s and 60s were dying sometimes at the same time they were, or before them. And it has to do with unhealthiness. It has to do with certain prevention things that we could have done. Stopping smoking, eating healthy, getting exercise. It's another thing that we pride ourselves here in wellness, the amount of sugary drinks that we drink. Pepsi and Coke, wow, it's out of control, people. And so I realized that that was something, and when I was lieutenant governor, and people don't like it even to now, I made it so that every single government agency on Guam has no smoking. And I had some of my own staff were telling me, man, but you can't do that. You know how far? I said, well, what do you mean? He goes, you can't make it no smoking. That's not right. I said, well, I'll tell you what. Why don't you prove to me in some way that smoking is good for you, then I'll reconsider it. Well, we did it. We took it out. We removed it. And now it's no longer in place. Even in the Department of Corrections, they don't allow smoking, right? So that was been my history. That's been what I wanted to do. So anyways, after I was a lieutenant governor, I was sitting in my office, and some of you guys know I'm a surgeon, and one of my former staffers, Andy, came to me one very busy day when I was in clinic, and he brought this bottle of VG7, I guess it was, or almost like it. And he goes, hey, doc, I just want you to try this, and let me tell you, see what you think. I said, Andy, I'm too busy. Don't bother me with that. And he goes, what is that? He goes, oh, it's some, you know, very healthy stuff. I said, I don't need that. Never mind, I just leave it there. Anyways, he left. And every time in between patients, I was looking at it, and I said, it has malundite. I said, hey, wait a minute. I know what that is. So as the half Filipino that I am, my grandfather moved from Lancaster, California, came to Guam, and he planted this one tree in the back of our house right next to our cesspool, and this big, huge malundi tree grew up. And in my mind, that was always something that was important to me. He always told us, you have to eat this, it's very healthy, it's very healthy, it's very healthy. So there was that. So then I'd go and see the next patient. And I looked and said, wait, Ampalaya, that's that bitter melon stuff. I know what that is. Again, I remember that as being very, very healthy. And so it piqued my interest. It got my attention. I said, what is this? So I called up Andy. He said, hey, Andy, what do you want me to do with this stuff that you gave me? I said, what is it you want? He says, well, I just wanted you to buy some maybe. Or by the way, doctors, you know, they don't sell this yet in the United States. And so I thought maybe you might want to consider being the distributor for it. Well, I'll tell you, it really piqued my interest. And so that evening, I went home and I decided to look up on the computer. You know, right now you can get information instantaneously as fast as you want. Not like before when I was growing up, you have to go to